Hello, I'm Robin Worley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today we're looking at the undo brush in Affinity Photo. This can be an incredibly useful tool, but it's often overlooked. It's also not that intuitive to use if you don't understand it, and even then you can sometimes get into a mess. To demonstrate the undo brush, I'll first apply some adjustments to this foggy landscape image I shot recently. First, I'll add a levels adjustment layer and use this to set the black and white points in the image. Whilst I'm doing this, I'll also set the gamma slider. Next, I'll merge the layers to a new layer and apply Knit Color Effects Pro to that. In Knit Color Effects Pro, I'll start by neutralizing the color cast in the image using the Pro Contrast filter. After that, I'll add a Brilliance and Warmth filter and use this to increase the warm light on the trees and the fields. I'll also add a small amount of perceptual saturation. After that, I'll save my changes back to the layer. Now I'm going to duplicate the layer I just adjusted. I'll then adjust the duplicate layer with Knit Vervaeza. In Vervaeza, I'll select the trees which are being caught by the morning light. To emphasize the light, I'll increase the warmth, contrast, structure, and saturation. Then I'll apply my changes to the layer and return to Affinity Photo. Now let's look at the History Studio panel. Here I can use the position slider to scroll back through my editing history. This allows me to see the buildup of adjustments I made to the image. As I'm doing this, I can see that I like the effect of the warm light, but the morning mist looks better before I made any changes to it. In fact, I like the mist best in the initial image. Ideally, I want to combine the mist from the starting image with my adjusted image. One way I can do this is to use a series of masks on each of the images to hide the adjustments I made. The alternative to this, and probably much easier solution, is to use the Undo Brush tool. You'll find the Undo Brush tool over in the Affinity Tools palette when you're using the photo persona. The icon is a paintbrush with an arrow through it. Select this and you'll see the standard brush controls appear in the context sensitive toolbar. You can use these to configure the undo brush tool just as you would any other brush tool. These can make painting with the undo brush tool and blending changes much easier. To explain how we will use the undo brush, I'm first going to set the hardness and opacity to 100%. This will make it easier to see the adjustments rather than if we try to blend them in. Before I can use the undo brush, I need to set a point in my editing history to use with it. I can do this in the history panel by clicking the small camera icon to the left of the editing point that I want to use. By the way, you can also change the history panel to show an advanced view which moves the camera icon. Back to the undo brush tool, and you can see what effect it will have if I paint as I move it over the image. But before I use the undo brush, I'm going to set the hardness to 0 and reduce the opacity to 20%. This will help me blend my brush strokes into the image. Now I can paint over the image where I want to return the mist to its original unedited state. As I paint, the undo brush is replacing my editing with the history point I selected in the history panel. Now, as good as this is, it's still taking me a lot of time to paint out the adjustments in the mist. It may be easier if I paint in my adjustments to the trees and leave the rest of the image unadjusted. To do this, let's delete all the layers we created so that we're back to the unedited image. I can then set the undo brush tool to the point in history before I deleted the layers. This allows me to paint the adjustments I created onto the trees and the foreground. Although we've been using the history panel to make these changes, we can do something similar using the snapshots panel. If your snapshots panel isn't visible, you can open it in the view menu. I'm now going to use the history panel to select the point before I deleted the layers so I can show you the editing again. Now in the snapshots panel, I'll click the camera icon at the top to create a new snapshot and call that colour. When you create a snapshot, you're saving a point in your editing history so you can use it again. Notice this snapshot entry has the same camera icon as we saw in the history panel. If I click this, it also sets the undo brush point just as it did in the history panel. I'll then delete the layers again as I did before. Now I can paint in the colour from the snapshot to the trees using the undo brush. It really is that simple, and you may find this is a possible alternative to much more complex masking. One final tip that I want to leave you with is to make sure you save your document history with your image file. You can do this by turning on the feature in the File menu. Then, when you save a file in the Affinity Photo format, it also saves your editing history. If you don't save it, the history is lost when you close the file, and this could prevent you from using the Undo Brush tool in the future. I hope you found today's video useful. I'm Robin Worley, you've been watching LensCraft, I'll see you soon for another video.